Hey guys, thanks a lot for joining me. This video is going to be my what I got for Christmas and my birthday, kind of a haul video, I guess. Just some really generous people in my life who gave me some awesome kind of beauty-related gifts. I do feel very fortunate that what I do for a living here on YouTube is my true, genuine interest in life, and I love how the two things overlap and the things that I just recreationally want to play with and that feel like my hobby. You know, it's makeup related stuff. My birthday is December 27th. That's 2 days after Christmas. And some of these things are Christmas presents, some are birthday presents, and I'll just jump in and share with you. And as for my parents, they do always ask me for like some specific things that I might be interested in because they really like to have some direction with the gifts. And I'm not gonna lie, I can be difficult to give to because I already own a ton of makeup things and a lot of the holiday stuff I already purchased. But there are still some things that I was really into and I thought you might be interested to see what those were. First off, this came from Nordstrom. It's the Smashbox Photo Op Mega Palette. Do you guys remember when there was a Mega Palette? It was actually called that very thing. It came out on QVC like, I don't know, was it 4 years ago? It was a red palette and it folded out with two sides and it had like every eyeshadow Smashbox made. It had brow stuff, it had blushes, it was like the whole nine yards, and I've never seen anything quite like that again from Smashbox. This does not really hold a candle to that in terms of size. It's this big, but it does have a lot of eyeshadows in it, and I just can't get enough of Smashbox eyeshadows. It's got a bunch of trios. You can see eight different trios there. Very excited about this one here with the gold and the burgundy. There's a great olive trio as well. So I think this is gonna be a lot of fun to play with because you have, you know, the direction for a quick look with the trios, but then you can totally mix and match throughout the whole set. There are three blushes in here as well. One thing that really baffles me is that the palette just folds together. There was no dividing sheet here, and that kind of bothers me. It's not like any of these products really generate a whole lot of fallout, but it's a situation where I'll definitely make a point to make sure there aren't a lot of loose particles when I go and push the palette back together. But you've got a very neutral peachy blush, a light pink, and kind of like a deep coral. But this was a Nordstrom exclusive, I believe, and I love Smashbox eyeshadows, so I was really excited to get that. Also from Mom and Dad, and I believe this came from Nordstrom as well, this is from Kiehl's, and it's the Ultra Facial Collection set. I'm really hoping in the new year to branch out into some new skincare type items. Just want to inform myself and educate myself more on different kinds of skincare. I've tried a few Kiehl samples here and there, and anything I've tried I've really, really loved. So this has the Ultra Facial Toner. I kind of love how simple and just classic this packaging is. It's got the Ultra Facial Cleanser. There's a little Midnight Recovery Concentrate. Really excited to try that. This is the Hydro Plumping Retexture Serum Concentrate. And then you got a good sized tub here of the Ultra Facial Cream. So I cannot wait to start using that. I haven't tried any of it yet. My skin, I can totally tell right now, the weather's getting colder. My skin is starting to get more dried out. And look at the inner part of this bag. Isn't that cute? Now you might remember last year I got this really cool like eyeshadow palette stack thing. I think it was called the Masterpiece Collection Remix or something from the brand called Shani. It was really cool how the palettes all like pulled out like drawers, and it was mostly eye palettes. There was one cheek palette in there, and I was really impressed with the quality of the eyeshadows, and I've been using them on and off. I really want to use more of them. But a cute little companion to that that I got this time is the Mini Masterpiece Makeup Kit. And so this is smaller, and it contains, right here you can see, it's all face related stuff. There are six separate palettes. I'll just pull them out for you and show you. There's a concealer palette with a bunch of different shades and some kind of corrector shades as well. Here's a powder blush palette with some kind of more natural type shades. There's a cream foundation slash, I can see that being like cream contour palette. There's a powder blush palette with a bunch of deeper tones. A powder blush palette with some super, super saturated colors. These kind of remind me of a few shades of the La Femme blushes that I have. And then down here you've got powders that could act as face powders, maybe a couple of them more contour type powders, but I'm just really excited to dig into this. I haven't used any of these yet on my face. I've just swatched a few shades here and there, but it magnetizes shut. It's a really nice little box set, and I'm interested to see if I like the face stuff as much as I like the eyeshadows. One other thing from Shani here is this natural look eyeshadow palette. Kind of interested to try one of their smaller sets. And it's just got a lot of really pretty neutrals in here. There's some metallic colors. The shades I'm wearing today, I've got like these two here in my crease, which this one's kind of peachy. It's really interesting. Got a little bit of rose tone to it. This is more plummy. I've got this matte peach on the inner part of the lid and the matte brown on the outer corner and kind of smudge below the eye as well. Really, really love the color selection in here. Just easy to grab for quick everyday looks. I mean, I knew I liked the quality of these shadows, but this is just a really great little palette. Another thing that I got, and these are so adorable, and they're even smaller than I anticipated, but they're really, really cute. It's from Charlotte Tilbury, and it's the Kissing, K-I-S-S-I-N-G, Fallen from the Lipstick Tree Mini Lipstick Charms. So you get this little box, and out come these three little lipsticks, and they've got the ribbon attached, so I think you could probably tie that up and like hang them, literally hang them on a tree if you wanted to. But there are three great, really creamy shades. I was wearing one of these the other day, and I just love the way it went on. And I have only tried the Matte Revolution lipsticks from Charlotte Tilbury's line, and this formula is just really, really creamy. It's very comfortable to wear, and so this shade is called, pardon my French here, Bitch Perfect, and it's a really nice, it looks like kind of a peachy nude. You've got Penelope Pink here, which is just a really delicate, pretty nude color. That was the only one I've worn so far. Then this red is called So Marilyn, and so that's just your really classic, kind of retro looking bright red. I really love these pretty rose gold tubes, and there's so much detail on the packaging too. There's little stars all across the top, and then the Charlotte Tilbury logo there. So cute. Now my sister Pup got me some really fun like accessory type items. She also painted me a gorgeous picture of Belle. She painted a photo that I had taken of her back when she was 10 months old, and she's standing in this little like floral outfit, and her little pose is just so cute, and I think she painted it with the thought that it would look really good here in the makeup room, so I can't wait to hang that up. It's gorgeous. And Pup also got me this really cool thing I cannot wait to try, because if it works, I see myself using it all the time. It's Lip Chic by Ella. It says transparent sealer for lipstick. It's got some instructions here that I'll need to read, and then it looks like clear nail polish. It says the transparent sealer for lipstick. Apply lipstick and blot with tissue. Brush with Lip Chic. Allow to dry, keeping lips apart. So we'll see how it goes. There are definitely some lip products that I own that I love the color of, but I would really love if they could have better staying power. So thank you, Pup. I can't wait to try that. Now my buddy David, I've told you he's an Estee Lauder makeup artist in New York. He has access to some amazing luxury products, and he completely spoiled me for Christmas and just gave me some amazing things, including these YSL Baby Doll Kiss and Blush products here. Now, I've heard about these, and I really think these are kind of a similar concept to my NYX Whipped Lip and Cheek products. You know a comparison is gonna be coming on those, right? But these, the shades are gorgeous. I am actually wearing the red on my lips today, and that's the extent to which I've tried them so far, is just this one shade on my lips. I haven't tried them on my cheeks yet, but it does feel super lightweight, but they're very pigmented. It's a little like wand applicator like that. This is shade 6. That's the red. I also have shade 1, which is that gorgeous pink, and then this coral is shade 13. Now, something David knows that I love are the Pure Color Envy Sculpting Lipsticks, not just for the quality of the lipstick, but also for the awesome magnetic closure packaging. You just cannot beat that. They're just luxurious. The colors are extremely pigmented, and they manage to wear a really long time while never feeling remotely drying on my lips. So he gave me several shades that I'd never tried, and I really do like to see what he recommends or what he chooses for me. So this shade is called Powerful. Isn't that gorgeous? It's so perfect. Impassioned is this really pretty, like, bright reddish orange shade. I think that's going to be awesome. As we head into spring, I love that kind of color. This shade is called Red Ego. It's a deep kind of brick red. And then this color right here is Insolent Plum. Look at that deep, rich, purpley berry shade. So awesome for wintertime. I think Estee Lauder has some of the best nail polish packaging in the business. This is the shade called Smashed. It's a gorgeous purple with kind of an iridescent sparkle in there. I think it's so, so pretty. I need to do my nails in a major way. David gave my sister like this really deep, dark, kind of almost blackish blue. So we're gonna have some dramatic nails happening in this family. Now, something I have never tried from Estee Lauder are the brushes, and this is the powder foundation brush. So I do own both the powder that's the loose kind and also the pressed double wear compact powder. So this feels really nice and soft. It's kind of like a full brush, but it doesn't fan out too terribly far. So I think I'm gonna like that for just control of the product. I really don't like my brushes to be too big, as I'm sure David has heard me say. So this is full without being oversized. So that's gonna be fun. I could see it being a good like bronzer type brush too. Okay, here's a brand that I am not familiar with whatsoever. And I've got a couple like kind of skincare type items here. Well, one's a primer. It's from Yves Lom and it's the Radiance Perfected Flawless Radiance Primer. It has an SPF 30 in it. And then this, I haven't even unwrapped it, but it says it's like a cleansing cream. The directions say apply cleanser to the face using circular movements, dip the muslin cloth in hot water and wring out, press onto the face, hold for 5 seconds, repeat 3 times, rinse the cloth in warm water, and remove all traces of makeup. I think this is gonna be a lot of fun to experiment with, and let's see what this primer looks like, because I can easily pull that out right now. Very cool, very luxurious looking packaging there. This primer really feels like a lightweight moisturizer. I wonder if he would recommend using it in that way. I don't know, my skin feels pretty hydrated after just applying that. So David, thank you so much. You know me well. I cannot wait to dig into more of those products and try them on for you guys. For my birthday, my parents gave me this set from Peter Thomas Roth. It's called Cucumber Detox Hydrating and Soothing Kit. It's got one of the gel masks, which I love, my Peter Thomas Roth Rose gel mask. So this is the cucumber one. It also has the Cucumber Detox Foaming Cleanser, the Bouncy Hydrating Gel, and these are the Depuffing Eye Cubes. So I think it'll be kind of like a spa type experience when I put these on. But I was so surprised to see this size on the mask in this kit, because this is the size I have in the Rose mask. And something I also love about his gel masks is that they don't have to be immediately rinsed off. Like if you just want to apply a thin layer, you can actually leave it on over your moisturizer, wear it overnight, and not like in a goopy way, but you know, just a thin amount of it, and you get like extra moisturizing, hydrating benefits. So I'm really pumped about this. I love how it kind of looks like green slime in there. And this is what that bouncy hydrating gel looks like. This is the foaming cleanser. And then the depuffing eye cubes. This says freeze, peel back, and pop out. So that's gonna be fun. I should like just shoot a video as I'm using this stuff and let you guys know how it's going. Again, my family really outdid themselves, but my parents also got me these Huda lashes, and these are in the style Samantha number 7. And I had been looking at these lashes quite a bit on Sephora's website, and I do follow Huda's YouTube channel. I think she's really awesome. And I am wearing the Samantha style right now, and these are just beautiful lashes, really well made. The band, the band looks thick, but it actually is surprisingly easy to work with, and the lashes really go all the way in on me to the complete outer edge of my eye. I probably could have trimmed these up a little bit, but it was kind of like they look so pretty I didn't want to touch them, so I just really made them work today, and they do feel really nice. Despite going all the way into my inner corner, these feel really comfortable on the eyes, and I just think they look so pretty. When you look at them sideways, they almost remind me a little bit of like the Ardell double stacks, in that they are just that fluttery. There's like layers of lashes in here instead of it being just one single, you know, swoop of lashes, for lack of a better word. So I'm loving these. These are like $20 lashes, so I don't have a lot of lashes like that in my collection, so it'll be interesting to see how well they hold up, how many uses I feel like I can get out of them, because they may be, you know, worth that price if I feel like I can use them all the time over and over again. Tyler, for Christmas, gave me a really amazing gift. He got me my first really, really nice luxury handbag, actually. And I had been thinking this over quite a bit, what I might want if I were to ever get something like this. And I was just feeling like a lot of the bags that I have are, you know, the larger ones that I carry, they end up all being really slouchy and just kind of like blobs. And I feel like I'm needing to carry more things these days with Belle. I like having a bag that's a little larger so I can take, you know, an extra diaper, some wipes, a toy, some food or something like that in there. And I also wanted something crossbody that would be a little bit larger than most of the crossbody things that I have. But, you know, it's just that fine line. And the bag that he ended up getting me is just so, so perfect in that respect. It holds a lot, but it doesn't overwhelm me. I'm only like 5 feet tall, so like if I'm gonna wear a bag crossbody, I don't want it to look like I've got this massive thing on my hip, you know? It's just a really beautiful bag. I see myself using it for years and years to come. It smells so good and so new. I really, really love it. Another cool thing that I wanted to mention that Bub got me for my birthday is a subscription to Wantable. And I wasn't really familiar with this service at all, but it's like you can get these monthly boxes of, it could be makeup, it could be accessories, I think even clothes and things like that, sent to you by stylists. They've looked at these little online surveys you've done and I guess put together a collection of things that you should like, judging by what you've said, or the things that would look best on you or work best for you. So I am really pumped to see what somebody might choose for me based on my preferences that I've laid out. So I think you can get different boxes each time depending on what you want, and I'm going to be getting them every month. So it'll be fun to show you guys what I end up getting through this. But the first one that I wanted to get was makeup, of course. But I'll totally branch out in future months and see what some of the other options are. But it seems like so much fun, and thank you so much, Bub. You completely outdid yourself this holiday. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. Gift giving is so much fun. It's really fun to be on the giving end, and it's always super fun for me when the gifts I receive are things that I can tell you about that are relevant to my channel, and that I just really genuinely enjoy. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.